did. His heart was moved with pity for them, for they were like sheep without a shepherd. And he began to teach them many things. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. It's wonderful that all of us are gathered here together again on this extremely beautiful Sunday morning, where many of us would like to go out to the parks or other places for recreation and to enjoy the beauty of God's creation. But it's wonderful that we at least have a priority in our life, and that is God first, and then the enjoyment of God's gifts to us as a second place. During this wonderful season of summer, we truly witness something very strange in our Catholic churches throughout our city of New York: a great diminishing of the number of people who are assisting at Mass. It's true, many perhaps go off to other places, to different countries in terms of tourists, or they go to their summer homes, but it seems as though there's a third element that many times we don't want to confront, and as a reality, I deeply am convinced of, that many people have put vacationing as a priority over loving God above all things. And that's where we really have to examine ourselves. Obviously, not you who are here, because you are here. But we have to examine, what is it about the way we conduct our Catholic Christian life that during the summer, so many people no longer come to church? Yes, as we mentioned, they may go to other places, but also there are many who don't go anywhere because they have as something that they feel is imperative in their life the necessity to enjoy themselves. It is important, as we see here in Scripture itself, what our Lord says and does. He has sent out his apostles to preach, teach, and cure. Remember, that's what we saw in last week's gospel. The apostles were sent out by Jesus two by two to be able to preach the repentance of sins, to prepare the people for the coming of the Messiah, who is Jesus himself. And of course, it would happen afterwards for the preaching and teaching of salvation that he would bring for us by his death on the cross, after the apostles would receive the gift of the Spirit in Pentecost. But he sent them out two by two, and he told them and gave them very strict instructions of how they were going to perform their duty of preaching and teaching and healing: to anoint the sick with oil, to stay in one house when they would enter a community, and to stay in that house until they would finish their task of preaching in that particular locality. And if a particular place did not receive them, to leave that place and to shake off the dust from their sandals of the place that would reject them. Jesus gave them specific instructions. And then when they came back together to our Lord after fulfilling the mission that he had given them, they were elated. They were filled with joy because they had seen that in his name they had expelled demons and the people were listening to him. And what did Jesus do? Let's go by ourselves to a deserted place and rest a while. Our blessed Savior knew the condition of human frailty, and thus he knew that after much work, it is important to rest. And that's why it's wonderful to have a vacation season. But above all else, God is first. And that's what I would think that's important for all of us when we speak with our friends and relatives, but especially with our children, grandchildren, godchildren, that it is important above all else to talk to God, to pray to God, and to worship God. It's very important. And one of the great sufferings, I would think, of many priests and pastors in our city of New York, and throughout our whole country, maybe unfortunately, but certainly here in our city, is the great question mark of our children of the catechetical programs. During the year, our church is filled with little children here. Thank God and the Holy Virgin for that. But during the summer, at this present moment, at this Mass, and almost all of our Sunday Masses, except, I must say, for the Spanish Mass, where they do come with their parents, here, not hardly one child. Thank God we have these two little fellows here helping us, and that's a blessing for us. But it is a question for ourselves. And we just cannot lift these things in the air. We must ask God, therefore, to give us the wisdom, the good counsel, the understanding of how to approach our catechetical, our religious instruction to our children, not just in our church, but in our own homes, because we are the first obligated persons to create Christian life in our children. How we can truly convince them, accompany them, encourage them, motivate them, urge them, obligate them to participate in their liturgies every Sunday. Because as you know so very well, we who are much older, beyond 60 years of age, the reason why many times we continue coming to church, if not every day, certainly every Sunday, this was inculcated in us since we were little children, 8, 9, 7 years of age. Every Sunday, no, whether summer or winter, spring or autumn, we had to participate. And we created this system within ourselves of the importance of God first before all other things. And that we have to return to with greater energy and with greater conviction. And it's a mission, a responsibility, a task, not just of the catechetical teachers who try their best and who are so wonderful in their self-giving. It's an obligation, a responsibility, a mission, a task for all of us without exception in our parish, in whatever way we can, to convince the parents of the children and to motivate the children to continue worshiping God even during the summer, because God still is our God, our Father, our strength, our refuge, and our Savior. And when we worship God, we experience, as the psalm says here in the Mass of today, freshness of spirit and energy to love Him and to serve others in His name. In the name of the Father, Son, of the Holy Spirit, Amen.